I'm going to introduce our next speaker, who is the, general manager of the Southern Electric Company of Hebron and the Palestinian region, Mr. Naif Al-Hur. And this gentleman here, I had a very nice experience with yesterday. I was standing at one of the booths, and we were presenting a window that is a dual season window that we've developed here in Israel. And Mr. Al-Nur came with his colleagues and started discussing the window, and it was incredible how many people these gentlemen and the gentlemen at the booth knew in common in a very friendly and warm-hearted way. So please, Director, please come tell us about your activities and your progress in your region supplying electricity using renewable energies.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. It's my pleasure being here at this conference. Special thanks to European Union Med-EMED Committee for facilitating my participation in this conference. We'll start about give you a brief about energy in Palestine. In the past, present, and very brief in the future. This presentation will show a brief about energy sector in Palestine, present the future situation covering all current energy sectors, including oil and gas energy in a brief, electrical sector in details, and renewable energy in brief also, because it will be covered by my colleagues. Palestine energy sources are petroleum and gas energy, electrical energy, renewable energy, solar, wind, geothermal, etc. Petroleum and gas energy. Petroleum and gas energy covers 50% of energy needing, most of it used as a fuel for vehicle, heating, air conditioning, and air, and which is big problem. It's an environmental and gas emission should be reduced to the minimum value possible. Electric energy. I'll go a little bit in details. Before signing the peace agreement between the Palestinian and Israeli in 1993, the electrical situation in the West Bank and Gaza was completely dependable on Israeli network. The Palestinian cities and villages were supplied through Israeli network through 276 connection points, you know, single islands here and there, through a grid 33 kilovolt and 0.4 kilovolt. Each connection point supply isolated small, insufficient network. This map shows those spread out connection points. Those connections are supplied through three main 161 kilovolt coming from Israel to the West Bank and Gaza area. Electrical system Palestine suffers from the following. We suffer more than 30% of Palestinian villages and communities were not electrified. You can't imagine in the year 210 people till now living without electricity. The network is not sufficient and built mainly of used materials because there was no organization with high technical losses. The size of connection port is small and the amount of power available is not enough because it depends on the command and the agreement between the customer or the village council or the municipality and the Israeli electric company. Standalone connection point without the ability to use power, spare power to move from one place to another because it's isolated and small islands. After peace agreement, the Palestinian Authority, PA, took responsibility for Palestinian areas. PA took several major steps toward regulating and upgrading energy sector as examples. They established the Petrol and Gas Commission, they established the Palestinian Energy Authority, and they established also the Research Center, Renewable and Environmental Research Center. C, renewable energy, mainly used for water heating, thermal, before the 1990s, and used to cover up to 12% of energy needed for the Palestinian areas. In the year 2010, the Palestinian energy sector is as follows. We'll give you a brief of the situation now. A Petrol and Gas Commission, after establishing the Petrol and Gas Commission, took responsibility and made several steps to organize and upgrade the sector. Licensing 261 petroleum stations and 52, because before that was like a mess, but now it's well organized. They licensed 261 petroleum station, 52 gas filling station in the West Bank and Gaza. Licensing 1,085 gas ceiling distributor to be around. All water should be renewed annually after meet all safety and environmental issues and regulations. All selling prices are fixed by Palestinian government as on monthly basis according to world market prices. Plans and needed budget to build two main storage facilities because we are now depending on daily supply from the Israeli market. Now they are working to build two storage facilities with needed labs are ready to be go live hopefully in the next year. The Palestinian Energy Authority put a master plan to upgrade electrical system which covers. Number one, establishing the distribution utilities. Southern Electricity Company, which I represent here, in the southern part of West Bank, start working in year 2004, serving about 500,000 residents with a total customer 70,000. Hebron Electricity Company, working in Hebron City, which serves 140,000 residents, total number of 32 customers. Jerusalem Electric Company, JETCO, in the middle part of the West Bank, including Jericho, working since 1914, so that's before, long time ago, serving about 900 residents with a total number of customers 203,000. Northern Electric Company, NEDCO, in the northern part of the West Bank, which started working this year, 210, which serves about 1 million residents with a total number of 200,000 customers. Gaza Electricity Company, JETCO, in Gaza, started working in the year 98, serving 1.5 million customers with a total number of 170,000 customers. And number two, establishing Palestinian Electricity Regulating Council, which is in charge of putting all laws and regulation to control the distribution. Which the main goals of this pair, licensing, generating, transmission, and distribution companies, because every working company in the field of electricity or energy should be licensed by the government. This council is responsible for licensing, regulating and regulating unified electrical tariff for Palestinian companies. Now, before every single city already have its own tariff, now there will be a common tariff for the whole Palestine. Working out all regulating laws and orders. Number three, establishing renewable energy research centers to follow up and regulate renewable energy issues. Four, establishing power generation company in Gaza, start working in 1998 with a capacity 100 megawatts, but now working with capacity less than 50% because of the lack of fuel. Establishing Jenin power generation station in north part of West Bank, which hope to go live with a capacity 200 megawatts, hope to go live in the year 2012. Number six, put plans and work to establish Palestinian Electrical Transmission Company, PETL, which will be responsible for buying electricity from generating companies and neighboring countries and sell to distribution companies. PETL hopes to go live in 2013. Number seven, signing agreement with the Palestinian will make several agreements. They sign agreement with Israeli Electric Company to collect the 276 connection points in four main connection points at the level 161 kilovolt and to minimize the cost and to keep power quality. Those two will be in the north part, one will be for JETCO and one will be in the southern part near Tarkovia. Number seven, signing agreement with Jordan to supply electricity to Jericho on 132 kilovolt line, which start working 2008 and now supplying 17 megawatt on the 33 kilovolt level. After finishing, we'll go to the 132. Number seven, signed agreement with Egypt to supply Gaza with electricity through 220 kilovolt line, which start working 2008 and now supplying 20 megawatt to Rafah area on 22 kilovolt level. Seven, put needed budget rules and orders to improve electric revenue collection, including replacing all metering system with smart prepaid meters to keep the collection rate in the set level. Number eight, put out need measures, rules, and regulation to energy saving program, including smart meters, smart houses, and smart grids. Palestinian current situation, our brief zone. This is the current situation. The electricity is supplied through 4 points. The main supplier is the Israeli electric company. Gaza and Jericho is supplied through Egypt and Jordan under the control of Palestinian Energy Authority. Future plan, the master will be, there will be agreement with Israeli company, Jordan, Egypt, and the private sector generator station. They will submit it to Palestinian Energy Transmission Land, and which will sit directly to the distributed utility who are in charge supplying the customers. Renewable energy. Still, the main use for water heating thermal usage for the rooftop water heating panels increased from 12% to 18%. We can see now more than 70% of Palestinian houses are served with solar water heating units. Solar photovoltaic still in minor scale. Still implement a pilot 12.5 kV PV system to electrify a small cold nozzle. 30 houses, many private small PV system also has been installed in rooftop off-grid system. Silco is in the final stage of studying 0.5 megawatt PV system to electrify public part and public building and 2 kilometer street lighting. Silco is in the final stage of study 5 megawatt PV generating or CPV, we have not decided yet, expandable to 50 megawatt according to financing. Wind energy still in minor scale. There's a project Al Ahli Wind Energy financed by the European Union. 0.7 megawatt project funded by EC is ongoing. That will be on grid according to the hybrid system, solar, wind energy to supply the hospital with needing. This is a picture of the hospital and the wind turbine. Silco studying a project for power from waste, which is just a dream. A feasibility study is ongoing. Figures are promising. Silco studying building 8 megawatt biofuel plants, which give chance for labors, planting a special plant. Pilot geothermal project is being tested in Ramallah. Related figures, I will leave them. By 2010, 90% of Palestinian communities have been successfully electrified. It was 30% without it. Now you can say 90% is now electrified. Population growth is very fast, from 2.7 to 2.10, from 3 million to 4.1 million, 65% in the West Bank and 35% in Gaza area. Number of customers also distributed with the utilities. Energy needed still, electrical energy is 30% of the energy. The rest is 69, which is, we should try to minimize and increase the renewable energy share. 88% of electrical energy for Palestinian market now is imported from Israel, the 165 kilovolt. The Palestinian load is 70% of the power generation capability of the Israeli company. Average power consumption also increased from 4 kilowatt, 402.5 to 700. It's increasing with a huge amount. There's an urgent need for energy saving program. Okay, that's because there's also good progress in the losses reduction. When the unit was down, it reduced from 40% to 05 to 32% to 8 to 26, and it's expected to go to 80% in 2011. Thank you.